Hello and welcome to the Calm News Channel. We're back at Airport CEO, and if you're looking at things closely, you can already see a very big difference. Like, this thing doesn't exist, this doesn't exist, this, when you look at it closely, doesn't exist, neither does this, or this, or I mean, when you scale out, certainly, and this thing certainly shouldn't exist, and these arrows are really weird. That's just an annoying piece right there, that should be there. Okay. So, let's get into it. Basically, I got big news for you. Alpha 33 is out on the experimental branch. I was literally jumping in my seat when I saw. And that means that I get to show you what it comes with. So, let's jump into it. The first thing is aircraft infrastructure. Obviously, there's a lot of stuff because that is the main part of the big word update. So we have the large stand in taxiway path for runway, security checkpoint, boarding desk, baggage bay, stand type. Upgrades. It can be converted to concrete and you can build a jetway. If you build a jetway, I'm not sure if I can do it right now. It is a double jetway. It's double, as I said. Let's see. We have two new airport utility buildings, they call them. There is a genetic structure and there is a blast fence. So this is genetic structure, this is a blast fence. As you can suspect, we have a de-icing pad. And then, the biggest one of them all, literally, the large runway. There's still some issues with it, because... Well, as I said, this was just released, as far as I know. But there is some new stuff I'll go over with the runway at a different point in this episode. But then other infrastructure we have, onto a different section. We have the option to have small crosswalks for single road, and we have double crosswalk for double road. And I'm guessing that is because of the implementation of something I'll point out in a moment. We have... parking lot, which I will also show you a cool feature in a moment. Or, not a moment, but I will show you a cool feature in this video. Then we have one-way roads, which, just quick thing, that's a little confusing about them, is, well, if you do this, then they won't actually come up. You have to do it on pre-existing roads. As you can see. That's really all there is for infrastructure, but there's quite a lot more cool stuff coming up eventually, so see you soon. Okay, so I've got another setup, and I told you I would tell you... Sorry about that. I told you I would tell you all about the parking lots, and, I mean, I can't really tell you much about the one-way roads, but I'll tell you about them anyway, just because they're there. Then also, this is demonstrating the use of one-lane crosswalks here, 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 and here. So, to tell you exactly what I remember from an earlier dev blog, they said there were two types of parking lots, which there's long-term and then there's short-term. All parking lots have 28 spaces, and here's how it works. So, parking lots have a long term, then here's how it's going to work. It's going to have a low turnout of vehicles, but on the other hand, they're going to pay higher per hour, and they're going to stay there for longer. I think so. And then in the short term, you will have a higher turnout of vehicles, but they will pay less per hour. So, there you go. That's how that works. And because I don't like that tree, I'm going to demolish it. Just random fact. Another thing I want to show to you is you can change the vehicle entry side now. Because of one-way roads, everything has a default entry side, but if you want to change it, and you will just click on the little slider here, and it will change it. As you can see earlier, I changed it and now it's on that side. So if I were to put one of these on a, let's see, put a contractor site on a one-way road, but that isn't going to work because, as you can see, the paint doesn't work very well. If you put it right there, and you can see it will come in on that side and leave over there because I had to switch it. Now, I don't need that, so I'm deleting it, but that's the basics of those things, and I will be back in about 5 seconds for you guys, about 5 minutes for me, on the next part of this. Okay, I'm back, and it's time for me to show you how, both two things, how baggage works for big birds, and just how the big birds work. So, let's get into it. Yeah, I've been getting that, ignore that, it doesn't matter, just pathfinding issue. So, first thing I want to show you is the baggage simulation. I'm going to speed up until we get some people. As you can see, people are dropping off the bags. I'm going to go underground and going through the scanning system, which I installed. And now, I'm going to go up. So, they're going through the scanning system and they're going to be dropped off here. You can see the usual procedure. Now, as you can see, a plane is coming. Now, look at this. This is a belt loader truck, which is actually the same name as the other one, but it's slightly different. As you can tell, it's a lot larger and it's different. And you will see in a moment. This is called ULD baggage simulation, in which there's two large things like that, and they will go on, and they will be brought down all the way down here, where they will be, the handling agents will take out the bags from them and put them in the conveyor belt system. And then, as you can see, they will also do the same for loading. They're loading up, and away this goes. Yep, and also there's a bug with the how that works that will probably be fixed soon, although the day one patch is already out. So out this goes, they're going to go up and in the plane, and that is basically all there is to it. Baggage bays now have to have, now instead of them turning around and going out, they go up and around, which I made use of one-way roads. See, is there really anything else? Yeah, I do want to point out that these planes carry large amounts of baggage. Can I see from this? Well, actually, it's not possible to actually see how much baggage these planes carry for some reason. It just says ULD baggage. But yeah, these planes carry a lot of baggage. Can I put pushback on this? I cannot. Instead of annoying. Well, anyway, that's it for ULD baggage simulation. I will be back soon with the rest. Okay, so after a while, actually, for me, this was actually over the course of a few days, due to the fact that I had to leave, we have an airport here, but I forgot to show you a part earlier, so I'm going to show you that, and then later I can show you this airport. So, something I would like to show you, can I move this? No, I can't move this, is, for one thing, I just noticed, you can add and remove approach lights. Now another thing also is that, and now instead of having a one type, just one runway, it's, three sizes of runway, and each size is associated with each aircraft, like the large one can support all three. As you can see, aircraft also have separate takeoff positions. This is small, medium, large. Now, there's also this option that does takeoff mode. So, takeoff mode is, will they just go from the nearest entrance, or will they go from... Takeoff mode is start of the runway, or will they go for more efficient where they need to be. And that's takeoff mode, so that's really all there is for that. And there's also something else called directional pushback. I cannot show you that as, actually I probably can show you that. Let me change something quickly. I'm just going to put in a small, because these have pushback. Then put in some taxiway. Long ways back, and I put in some path. I believe it appears that pushback, I can't get pushback to work, but there is directional pushback according to I don't know why I can't get it to work, but there is directional pushback. I don't know why I can't get it to work, but there is. I also colored everything my color. So yeah, that's it for now. And I'll be back in a moment to show you this airport. Okay, now I'm going to be showing you how the big birds work. And, one thing I cannot show you is this, and even I have not seen it, because I've not been able to get it to go yet. But besides that, I can show you the whole process. So we'll start with, let's see, this will be a taxi. So we'll start with taxi coming up here. Going all the way around here, doing a U-turn, loading up, but people will come on, and as soon as a flight comes in, then as soon as you can see, it appears that a flight is just about ready to go, so everybody's coming in. And also, I always forget you're supposed to put seating in here. But anyway, they're coming in, the bags are going through. The usual procedure, they go into the cargo bay. They're doing the ULD baggage thing I showed you earlier. As you can see, people will come through security, still the usual procedure. They will, appears to go into gate 2. I'm going to have to do a little bit of magic, because that was taking too long. But away it goes. And off come the next passengers. Pathfinding is being worked out. But off they come. And then, as you can see, there are, for one thing, the fueling of these things takes a long time due to the, like, two fuel trucks were ordered for the fueling of just one. Which means you should probably get double the amount you normally would. Normally there's two catering trucks, the second one is coming along right now. Cleaning is in progress. Don't know where they went, but that's happening. So cleaning is in progress. The baggage is going away. Being refueled. And then in a moment, boarding should start in a moment, and, oh, I probably shouldn't wait, but, and then, the big differences is, just the vehicles and the graphics. So, like, there's a ULD, and then there's a large pushback truck. That's mainly it. Stands are pretty big. It requires a 7-wide, pathway to do it. Also, it appears they didn't figure out the timing completely because the fueling is taking a little bit long, which seems to be a slight issue. But besides that, yeah, that's really it. Going from when it's remote stands or stands without jetways, it will be like, as you can see, the offloading is the usual, to go through there, get the baggage, which I actually really want to see how this works because I haven't seen it yet. Also, this is normal, I don't get it still, I think it's just the pathfinding updating. They're going to sit down, most of them are going to wait for the baggage. Should be coming in a moment. Yep, here. This one was a very large flight by the looks of it. The baggage is coming along, and it's about to rain. The baggage will be coming along. Here's the baggage. We're gonna go in a circle. People are gonna get up. We're gonna get the baggage. We're gonna keep going around until it reaches. For me, it's just gonna go in a forever circle now. Which seems to not work by the looks of it, because it looks like they just, nope, they're going to get it. Anyway, then the next round will come through for boarding. As you can see, this plane is about to be ready for boarding. Also, as you can see, this does not actually have a flight, this won't actually tell you how many bags there are. Changing this. Okay. Are we gonna board? Because of cleaning? Well, whatever. I think it's still the same number of ramp agents, I'm not sure. Could be more. Yeah, but that's really it. That is never going to be built. But same number of ramp agents, same stuff. See. You covered all that stuff. Same buildings. Nothing different. That, which I already told you about. Large one of these. Pathway is the same, you have to use the large runways, and that's really it. So thank you for watching, have a good day, and goodbye.